Hey everyone, I'm actually back in South Carolina. I decided to drive back with Laura. Today, we are leaving for Florida. So I've done a lot of traveling, basically all of June. I went back for the week of tryouts for cheer and I left again. Because of how much I've been traveling recently, I decided that this week I should talk about how to travel in a more eco-friendly way. Obviously, the best thing that you can do for the environment is stay at home, but that's not human nature. That's not how humans have ever worked. We have this inner urge to explore the world, at least most of us do, and I'm definitely one of those people. A lot of times when we travel, we create a lot of waste, produce a lot of emissions. We do things that are harming the environment more than helping. It's just about being conscious and learning how to make intentional decisions. When I'm planning a trip, the first thing that I think about is, can I drive? Or do I have to take a plane? If there is an option to drive, you should always opt for that because planes create an incredible amount of greenhouse gas emissions, and that is directly related to climate change, and if we can avoid it, we definitely should. So always drive when that's an option, even if it's slightly less convenient. Personally, I live a plant-based lifestyle, but I know a lot of you don't, and so if you do eat meat and dairy, when you go on vacation, I would recommend trying to eat more plant-based, just so that you can offset the emissions that you're creating when you travel. If you're looking to travel more sustainably, the next thing I would recommend is to act like a local. To me, this means buying groceries, and this is harder if you're in a hotel room, but personally, like, I'm staying with a friend, or you can stay in an Airbnb where you would get the option to cook in a kitchen. And when you buy groceries, you're not creating as much waste as if you were to go to a restaurant or eat out at fast food, especially if you're eating plant-based. And in addition to that, I would try and eat local food. So if the area you go to, the main dish is based around beans and rice, try and do that because one, they're probably going to be locally sourced, and two, it's part of the experience. I also like to ask around for recommendations rather than doing the more touristy things. If you talk to the locals, I know it can be intimidating, but they usually know the spots that, you know, online travel websites wouldn't, and it can really enhance your trip, and then you're also usually going to be spending time outside. Be brave, ask locals, make conversation, and enrich your vacation with memorable experiences. The next one's super obvious, and I say it all the time, but you should always bring reusables with you. Water bottles, utensils, reusable Ziploc bags. These are going to save a ton of waste, especially if you're packing snacks and things like that. And if the area that you're going to doesn't have clean water, you can always buy a water bottle with like one of those filter pumps. I'll try and find one and link it in the description below so you can check that out. I personally don't have one, but I've also never been to an area where the water is unsafe to drink. I'm sure it'll happen one day and hopefully I'll have a water bottle like that. And the last thing, as tempting as it may be, try to avoid those gimmicky tourist trap souvenirs. 99% of the time, they're things that you look at or they're toys that break and you have to end up throwing them away. If I do buy souvenirs, I'll buy like t-shirts or I really like hats. I try not to buy sunglasses because I lose them all the time. In general, I don't buy a lot of souvenirs. I really like to take pictures and that's how I kind of collect memories, and I'll print out like my best ones and hang them up on a wall. So you could do that too. Obviously, if it's digital, it's a lot less wasteful than souvenirs. You know, find what works for you. I hope some of these tips helped you. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoy traveling, and that's probably impossible. And that's all I have for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week, and make sure to give me a huge like and subscribe. It means so much to me. Thank you to all of my subscribers that I have now. I'm almost to 50. Woohoo! I'll see you guys next week. Peace!